マジノブチャンネルです。トロントのノジです。
ロンドンのノブです。
よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
はい、今日は第15回目の、ノジノブチャンネルになります。今回はですね、私たちの、トランスレーションの、添削、英語の添削を行ってくれているジョイさんのインタビューシリーズ第1弾になります。はい。よろしくお願いします。
お願いします。ですね、ジョイはですね、イギリス人で、彼女は鍼灸師です。で、私も鍼灸師なんで、偶然同じセミナーで会って、意気投合して、で、彼女はすごい、英語、スペイン語、フランス語、あともう一個できるのかな。で、そういろんな、言語ができるってことで、あ、彼女もしかしていろいろできるのかなと思って、声かけてみてお願いしたら、心よく承知して、サブタイトル付けに協力してもらいました。
はい。ノジは会ったことありません。
はい。でもすごい本当に人生豊富なユニークの方で、本当にいろんな楽しい話を聞けると思うので、今日は彼女のインタビューをノジと私でしたいと思います。
イエーイ。
じゃあ早速ジョイに入ってもらいましょうね。
はい。
ジョイさん。はい。ジョイ、カミン。ジョイ、カミン。Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Joy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you guys?
I can't see you.
Well, I'm waiting. Yeah, it's coming up on the computer screen, I think.
Hello. Okay. Hi. Welcome.
Hi. Our channel.
Hi. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you very much for coming today.
Thank you for inviting me.
We are so excited about interviewing you. So, she's Joey, she's an acupuncturist and with our friend. So, we're going to have an interview to Joey to hear her lots of experience and also interesting story. So, let's get started.
Okay.
So, firstly, we have a 3 questions, and I'm going to ask you about your language skill. You speak, how many languages do you speak?
English.
Yep.
French.
Yes.
Spanish.
Great.
Portuguese.
Yes.
And I studied.A little bit of Japanese.
Oh, God.
Oh, and
can you speak Japanese? Do you have any?
But very little. Yeah, I studied a lot, but it's quite difficult for me to speak.
Great.
とても難しいです.
Oh, fantastic. Well done.
But I also studied two.African languages as well, university. I studied Yoruba and Hausa.
Wow, fantastic. So, I'm going to have an interview and I'm going to have a question to you. The first one, how to manage and speak so many languages? Tell me.
Okay, well, the first language,was French. I studied in school, and in England, that's what we do. We study French. Oh. Nowadays, they do different languages, but way back in the 60s, wow. when I studied, French was the traditional language to learn. Mm. And I like words. I like learning about new words. Mm. You know this when we do the subtitles.
Yeah.
I always try to find a synonym.
Yes,
another word.
You find a synonym always.
Yeah. And so I like to know the origin of words, where they come from. And English, a lot of it comes from the Latin language.
Yes.
And also the Greek language and German. So I love to find a word and explore where did this word come from?Mm-hmm. Which country? Why? How did it change? Because language changes as well.
Yeah,
you know, a word that meant something in the 18th century now means something completely different. And it continuously evolves. Okay. Children, when they're texting on their mobiles, they change language, you know, and language is something dynamic. Yeah. And I love words. I love working with language. But also, yeah. I'm a very nosy person. Yeah. Nosy means you want to know what's happening. So if I went to Spain or Brazil or any country, I want to know what people are saying.
Oh, I see.
I like to join in, you know. Yeah. I want to know why people are laughing. Mm-hmm. Why? What was the joke? What did they say?
Yes.
So that made me want to learn languages.
Okay, so, that's why. So you have a lot of language.
Yeah, yeah. That's exactly the way.
Wow, fantastic.
Fantastic. So you are a very curious person, right?
Very, very.
Yeah, very nice. So keep your brain working hard.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Great.
Well, great. Thank you so much. I'm so really, really interested in your the story of the language.
So, yeah, we got the tip of the language, how to, you know, deep inside, you know, from you.
Yeah, I think it's also to not be afraid. I have taught language. I've taught English to students in England and also in Brazil and also in Cuba. And when you teach students who are very shy, you tell them, you will never learn if you don't practice, if you don't try. And they say, oh no, I'm so afraid I will make a mistake. And you say, it's good to make mistakes because that's how you make a progress.
Yeah,
if you don't try, you will never progress.
Yeah.
And I think that's true of anything in life. Whether you are learning to paint or whether you are learning to play a musical instrument, you have to make mistakes in order to get better.
So I'm
fearless. I don't care if I make a mistake in French or Spanish or any language. So, you know, maybe I say the wrong word and people start laughing. But then you learn, you say,
yeah.
Okay, that's why they laughed. I used the wrong word. Nice. Yeah.
Yeah. Same thing. Yeah. Even when we speak English, we always speak very, very carefully. But then,
yeah,
the Japanese feel afraid to make a mistake and they can't speak, but
yeah,
they never get improved.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
It's true. Yeah. But having said that, with Japanese, I'm very nervous of making mistakes because your language is very precise. I cannot speak the same way to a child as to an older person, or, you know, the language is different depending on who you are speaking to. And that is very defined in Japanese culture. And in English, it's not like that, you know. It's true. It's true. Yeah. So I am very afraid of making mistake in Japanese.
You speak Japanese really well.
Like, no, I don't.
Yeah, be confident. You are very good.
Yeah.
But anyway, thank you so much for your story. So another question from Noji, please.
Oh, yeah. Another question. Second question is, what is your most interesting event in your life or interesting things for you?
Okay, all right. Well, I have five. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm old and I've had a long life and I've traveled everywhere and I've met many interesting people and I've seen a lot of things. Mm-hmm. I've seen a lot of great music. I've seen a lot of great culture and events.
Yes.
And so I have so many to choose from. But for today, I've chosen five.
Great.
So the first thing, the thing I really, really love is to be in nature. I love gardening. I have even picked some flowers today.
Where the interview. You pick up somewhere beautiful.
And I spent many years gardening when I first came back from traveling, when I was 16, I went to India and I lived in India for a year. And then I came back and I studied at school again. And then I went back to India and lived there again for a year. And I was learning meditation and yoga and all of these things. But when I came back to England, I wanted to work in nature. So I got a job as a gardener. And I worked in gardening for maybe 10 years before I started doing other work. Yeah, so gardening for me is really special. And I love to be, you know, in the trees, in the mountains, by the water. So for me, that's my favorite thing because it gives me peace of mind. It gives me tranquility.
Right.
And I love it, yeah. So that's the thing that is always in my heart. Wherever I am, I need green things, yeah?
Yeah.
But the event that was the most interesting for me, or the most fun, was the Olympics in London in 2012, because I had the good fortune to work in the Olympics as a volunteer.
What did you do?
I was the driver, the translator, and the personal assistant for the vice president of the International Olympic Committee from Cuba. And I worked with this Cuban man who was an ex-basketball player from Munich, from the Olympics in Munich. And I had, my job was to drive him everywhere.
And in London?
In London, for the Olympics.
Oh.
And as the driver, I should not have been allowed to go inside. I was meant to leave him in the door and then go to the car park and wait for him to call me on the mobile to pick him up. But I am a rebel. I cannot do that. So I went to Primark and I bought some very skinny trousers and a t-shirt and I put it on underneath my Olympic uniform.
This
was me in the Olympics
in
London 2012.
Yes, great.
And I was very proud to be in the Olympics because I am a Londoner, and it's the only time in my life that the Olympics will be in London. So it was special for me. Anyway, so I would drive this man to the event, whether it was to see Usain Bolt or, you know, Mo Farah or boxing or anything. Mm-hmm. And I would make him come to the car park. We would walk to the events in the Olympics, and I would go in with my Olympic uniform, and then they would stop us in the gate and they would say to him, please come in. But to me, they would say, no, you don't have the accreditation to go inside, please go. And then he would say to me in Spanish, what did they say? And I said, well, they said I cannot go in. And he said, ignore them, come with me. And then the English people would say, what did he say in Spanish? And I would say, he speaks no English. He needs me as his translator.
Oh,
I have to go inside. And then they would go to get security and he would go, quickly, go and sit. And I would go far away from the VIP seats, take off my clothes, my Olympic clothes, and have my jeans and my t-shirt underneath. And I saw everything. I saw Usain Bolt, I saw Mo Farah, I saw all the big events, even in Wimbledon. I had the best summer ever.
Well done.
Really, the Olympics was
wonderful.
Picture, if you would like to see. I try not to take too long. yeah, it was really special. I was invited to the opening.
Were you doing opening ceremony?
and the closing ceremony.
Oh, that's what.
Oh, oh, that's you. That's you.
So yeah.
Yeah. Wow, fantastic.
Sorry?
Fantastic.
Yeah, no, the Olympics for me was very special.
Yes.
And I have a confession to make, because one day when I was parking the Olympic car, the man already went inside to an activity, and these guys came and said, oh, you're working in the Olympics. And I said, yes. They said, do you have any spare tickets? And I said, well, actually, I have one ticket for the closing ceremony. And they said, how much money? Because people were trying so hard. And I told them a price, quite a lot of money. And they said, we want it.
Really?
And they bought the ticket. Mm-hmm. And with that money, I went to Japan.
Oh. Wow, so much money.
Yeah. Good idea. You could
turn. It was great. So the Olympics for me was special because I saw an amazing, mm-hmm. you know, event of athletics and everything. And it was great weather and a great atmosphere in London. Everyone was so friendly. Plus, I got the money to go to Japan for my seminar of acupuncture in Shimosaka. Yeah.
Nice.
So, number two. So number three was very briefly when I had the opportunity as a young person to see Jimi Hendrix live in the Isle of Wight.
Wow.
That was sad. I have no photos because it was 1969.
Oh, before we were born.
Yeah, but I saw Jimi Hendrix, so that was great.
You're lucky. I wish I could see him. Yeah.
Very, very lucky. Mm. So number four was when I was in Japan, my favorite memory, my most special day, and I've had many special days, was going to Fushimi Inari.
Oh,
it was so special. And I have a couple of photos if you would like to see.
Yeah, I want to see.
Of course. So why not?
Yes, okay.
Yeah, sure. Fushimi Inari is in Kyoto?
Yes.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I've been there before a few times. It's it's peaceful and very traditional, special place.
I spent a whole day climbing.
Well, climbing? What?
Yeah. In
Fushimi Inari?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's a little mountain near Gion.
Oh, near Gion. Yes, near Gion. Yeah,
I think.
Yeah.
I'm not sure, but I think. Wow.
Yeah, it's a lovely color.
It's the Tories. Mm-hmm. Hundreds and hundreds of Tories.
Yeah.
Tory.
You say Tory?
Yeah, Tory.
Tory.
Yeah.
It's so beautiful. It's
wow, beautiful.
It's beautiful, yeah.
When I was in Japan, I was very lucky. I went to many shrines, Shinto shrines, and, you know, other temples, but Zen temples. But Fushimi Inari for me was special. It had such a great atmosphere. It's in the mountains. And I just climbed all day. And I had lunch there, which I will show you.
You were so
and I just have a great memory. Yeah, you can see I was very,
okay.
Sorry.
Oh,
I was so happy.
Thank you.
I was just so happy.
Couple of plants.
Sorry, it's difficult for me to get the photos, but nearly there.
It's the same time at Osaka?
Yes, after the seminar, I stayed another 10 days.
Oh, that's nice.
I don't know if you can see properly here.
A little more closer, yeah.
This is in the afterwards. I climbed up the mountain, yeah. And then I climbed down the mountain again. And what I love, I mean, I love Japan, and I love everything, you know, the culture. I've been involved in Japanese culture since I was very young, because I studied martial arts with Sensei Suzuki when I was 16. But I love the food in Japan, I love the bonsai, I love the nature, I love everything. So going to Japan after the Olympics was very special for me.
Yeah.
And the fifth thing that is really special is when I was living in Cuba, the Rolling Stones.
Yeah, that's that's a pop. I know.
I was very, 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 very lucky because I'm British, and the British ambassador invited me specially to a private party with the Rolling Stones, and I met Mick Jagger.
Oh my God!
Yes.
Yeah, he's stunning. Oh, he's musical. Famous.
So I'm very, very,
very, very nice.
I'm very proud of my photo with Mick Jagger. So these are five of my favorite and interesting things and events. I have many more, but we don't have so much time.
Yeah. Maybe next time.
Yeah, next. Thanks for sharing it, you know.
It's really nice.
Okay, the third question is, what is your life theme?
Okay, so I was thinking about that, and I was thinking, I've done many different things, but there's kind of a continuity. Because as I said just now, when I was 16, I was studying martial arts. But when I went to India, I was studying meditation and yoga. And then when I came back to England after working doing gardening, I went to a monastery in Scotland, a Tibetan monastery, because David Bowie was friends with my mother. And he used to come to our house to collect antiques, because my mother was an antique dealer. And David Bowie went to this Tibetan monastery, Tibetan Buddhist monastery. And I thought, I think I'll go there. So I decided to go just for 3 days, and I stayed 1 year.
That's a life.
So, yeah, it was really special. So I did a lot of meditation there, and you know, met a lot of very holy, very spiritual people. I was very lucky, very blessed, very privileged to have met a lot of the people I've met. And then later I studied shiatsu, and then later I studied acupuncture. And these are things that have a spirituality to them. Yeah, it's not like, I don't know, I can't think of what to say, but it's a special kind of work. When you are healing and working with people, it's a spiritual connection, yeah?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So I think that the theme of my life has been trying to learn to be aware of who I am spiritually.
Cool.
Yeah. I think that's what I can say. I mean, it's a big subject.
Yeah, it's really huge.
In a small way, I think that's it. So the theme of my life has been trying to remind myself why I am here on this and trying to be as spiritual as possible. But it's hard work. It's hard work, you know.
But it seems to me you continuous, you know, since your younger time, and already in the how is it called? You gotta always pulling, how can I say, like your path, you know, what's in the world and you're interested, like you grab it continuously to build up your curiosity for in your heart.
Yeah, yeah, that's
cool. All the connection to the spiritual, you know, like surrounding you and more must be you're comfortable, you know, like more and more, and then you understand yourself and more understanding yourself, I think, right now, right? More understanding as your past years and experience, I think, you know? So this is the also the same message to the public, like anything you like to share?
Yeah, just three words.
Okay, because your old experience looks to me like a great spirit, you know, to something to share to the public, you know, like, or as a person, okay, like, I want to know.
Yeah, I don't know about that, but I think I'm quite an old soul. I think I've been to this planet many, many, many times, and I still haven't learned everything I have to learn. But if there were three words I would say, especially now in these difficult times, many, 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 many years ago, when I was in India, there was a man there from America, and he later wrote a book. And the book, the words on the book were, be here now. And I never ever forgot those words. And basically, when we do meditation, or if we do yoga, or if we do qigong, or if we are doing whatever we are doing, we try to just be here now, whether we are following the breath, or whether we are, you know, walking to catch the train or the bus, we have to try to be here now. And, you know, it is a difficult time with the COVID and all of that and all the terrible negative things in the world. It's a very difficult time. So I try, for my own sanity and peace of mind, to surround myself, as I said, with nature. And to be here now as best I can. That's all I can say.
Great.
Great.
Yeah. Great word.
Yeah, yeah. So impressed. Very, very impressed.
Mm-hmm. Nice word. I think I like that too.
Yeah.
I really like it. Important for us. Eh?
Yeah, always been my
thing. Always.
Yeah. That's really good. Mm-hmm.
Today is a full moon and Halloween. Halloween day, right? So enjoy yourself for the full moon light and make a you know, remember the blue water, if you like, make it moon water, something to focus on the moon, like, okay. So thank you so much, Joy, and then see you soon.
So we're gonna do ciao. Thank you.
Ciao.
See you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay.